Eagle Eye Football here with JC. It finished Palace 0, Manchester City 1. And it's the hope that kills you, innit? When you're, what, 15 minutes away from a well-earned point. Thoughts on the game?
It's disappointing to see that we only start playing at 85 minutes. It's good though, it's improvement, because normally we only start playing football at 90 minutes, so we've improved 5 minutes, so well done Palace for that. Very proud of you guys. But it's just a disappointment, isn't it? It's the team that is fighting only start fighting when you're 1-0 down. And you know what? Honestly, I think if we didn't go 1-0 down, we won't make those changes. We wouldn't have made those changes if we didn't go 1-0 down. And honestly, without that lapse in concentration, I think this game ends 0-0.
And that's something we definitely would have taken.
Oh, I'm taking it. We were taking some good draws against some big teams, Newcastle, Man United, just to name a few. But it's just a disappointment. I don't know whether it's a lack of ambition or what, but the players that we have are good enough to start. I don't know what's happened with Eze. He only seems to play well when he comes off the bench. Edward, I think when he came on, he tried to do the right things, but I think when you realise that he wasn't getting the ball to feet, he just turned off and switched off completely. But if there's ever a cameo to cement yourself to have a start in the next game, it's Ahamada. This guy came on and changed the game for us. His defence, normally his defending isn't the best, but it is much, much, much improved now. And just his ability to drive with a ball, pick up the ball from deep, drive forwards, dribble with the ball, anything. He was there. He's got good pressing, good energy. He was the only one pressing Edison at the end of the game. He was further forwards than Edward. He was further forwards than Eze. Those guys are meant to be more advanced players than him. But, you know, I'm calm.
Wilfred Zaha. Now, we've all said that we don't want him playing up top. When things are not going his way, it's like we're playing with 10 men at times.
I wouldn't say we're playing with 10 men, because it's very, we know this historically, if you put him up against a centre back, he can't do nothing. And you know what they played as a back four today? 4 centre backs. So you really think that he's going to do anything up front today? It's not going to happen.
Correction, they played 1 centre-back today. I'm saying
they played 4 centre-backs. I'm not saying that they played in the centre-back position. Because, mate, I saw John Stones down the wing, through the middle, Nathan Ake playing up top. I'm thinking, mate, what is happening? But you know what? With Zaha, his legs are gone. I think it's a bit of a punching situation right now. He's so slow that you can put a through ball in and they can run around him now. Normally, when you've got a situation like that, you're not running around Zaha. Zaha will overtake you, but Akanji, I don't think he's the fastest guy in the world, overtook Zaha. John Stones overtook Zaha. His legs are gone and his attention and his tempers, he just snaps so easily these days. Normally it would take him a little while to get round up, but one altercation with John Stones and his head's gone. He even started having a go at Ayew for a little while. I'm thinking, listen, Ayew could have done nothing else. There was one point where Ayew had no choice. He went all the way to the throw-in line and booted it as far up the line as he could. And guess what? Zaha was nowhere to be found when he asked for that kind of ball. And he still had a go at Ayew for doing exactly what he wanted. Zaha needs to get his act together, man. I know he wants to have a good final year, wants to have a good send-off, but, mate, you've got to get your act together if you want to do that, because right now, I wouldn't say he's ruining his legacy, but he's leaving a sour taste in everyone's mouth if he goes after this season.
I would say it was good to see Eddie come back on today, but it's almost as if he didn't care.
Yeah.
I mean, it is difficult, obviously, coming on with 15 minutes to go and stuff. Like, you're thinking, why are you playing me now? But just show a bit of fight.
Yeah, I mentioned it. He came on when he didn't get the kind of balls into his feet, what he wanted. He just switched off, didn't he? He was a fresh guy on the pitch, and I don't think he pressed the goalkeeper. He was running around. He did a few nice flicks and tricks. 2-foot passes, offside. come on, man. You're offside and it's his positioning's dreadful. I think that it could be a thing of he's got a bit of rust on him, he hasn't played, he hasn't stepped on a football pitch in a while. But still, if you want to get on that pitch, you need to show that you mean it. He didn't show much desire there, did he? Whereas if you look at who we just mentioned, Ahamada, he's trying. You can tell. I want to have a special shout-out to Luka today. Honestly, we all know what Luka does. I'm genuinely surprised he didn't get booked in this first 10 minutes. Honestly, he lasted 30 minutes. I'm actually surprised at that. Because, to be honest, I think in 30 seconds, he nearly wiped out Rodri. And I think, we know what we get with Luka. Yeah. You pass the ball to him, he don't know how to pass. He's slow on his feet. His passing's not very accurate, but he gave it his all today. And that's something we've been missing in the midfield. And he's a leader. Yeah. He marshalled that midfield very well. But, you know, it's Luka in it. You're not going to get a world-class player there. But we got what we needed out of him today.
Just quickly on Sambi Lokonga. Now, we've been obviously... We were very critical of him against Villa and stuff. Oh, interesting. I personally thought he had a better game today, considering Decore wasn't there. But go on, criticise, go on.
I'm still critical because of when we play teams that are not in the big six. When they don't press you as much as other teams will. For example, at Villa, we got pressed. He didn't have no time on the ball. City, they give you time on the ball. They let you make your own mistakes. In that case, Lokonga will thrive. And we've seen it against Liverpool, against Newcastle, against Man United. He plays well. However, against Villa, when he's got no time to think, when he's being pressed, he's dreadful. And I think today's game has solidified that for me. Yes, he played well today. I'll give him credit for that. But to be in an Arsenal team and to be in our team right now, what games have we got coming up? We've got two more games of people that don't press. Then again, Brighton do press. So, what, one game against Arsenal?
He'll miss that game anyway.
Yeah, he won't even play. He's on loan. So, all the games that he's struggling is going to be from Arsenal until the end of the season. I'm not too convinced with him. Because if he can't play against that Villa team, and to be fair, they don't press as much as some of the other teams, like Leeds and Leicester, where he's going to struggle a lot. I know he's going to have Decore, and that's going to help, but Lokonga, I think we're seeing the reasons why he got loaned out. Because if he was solid as he is against these guys, as he is against lower teams, bottom 10 teams, then he wouldn't be with us right now. He'd still be in that Arsenal team as a rotation player, but he's not. He's here. And I think that's where I stand on it.
Man of the match.
You can give it to Ayew, you could give it to Anderson, you could give it to Gueye. But I really don't know. It's hard to pick. I'll probably say Anderson because he kept Haaland very quiet. I think he's done a job on Haaland, he's done a job on Nunes. So, yeah, I'll give it to Anderson. I think he was the standout player today. Marshalled the defence, stopped Haaland, still got some good long balls in there, and very steady head. I'll give it to Anderson.
JC, up the Palace.
Up the Palace.